Hello, I'm Ingo, and I like to show you today how to make a nice gluten-free bread. A few things are important while we produce our breads, such as a water temperature, not too cold, the dough temperature not too cold, but furthermore, the key ingredients. All the ingredients from our bread mix are certified gluten-free. It's a very important part. So, we use the gluten-free bread mix, yeast and oil and water, not too cold, like I said. And we mix 2 minutes slow and 7 to 8 minutes fast. Let's start. So, not too fast inside because the starch flour have a lot of dust. All right. Our oil we can put straight away inside. We use 88% water. And let's go. 2 minutes slow, 7 minutes fast. Ready to go. So, now our dough is finished. The dough is now very sticky, creamy, but I have a good tip for you. Use some water on your hands and on your scraper, and it will be very easy to take out. Now it's very important, after mixing, we start straight away scaling, shaping, and finishing the bread. Only gluten-free bread, we go straight through. No bulk fermentation required. This is the most critical point. All right, we scale the dough, 500 gram. And now you will see one part. The first breads will be still quite sticky, but after a few breads, you will see the dough dry up very fast. This is the reason why we don't make bulk fermentation. And one important step is don't use too much of the mix. Just dust slightly so that we don't separate the dough. Don't forget, this is not bread flour, this is mainly starch what we have. Important now is handle the dough like a cookie dough. So we don't have to mold, it's just the shaping of the dough. Or rolling, just roll it into a loaf, and you see, I nearly need nothing to dust. It's very nice. We can use our gluten-free bread mix also as a topping, so the bread look more like a natural bread. Just shaping, rolling. Same like a cookie dough. Right? Push a little bit flat. We can make also different shape. We just make a bread knot. All right, so you see, even different shapes, no problem. Now we let it prove for approximately 40 minutes to 60 minutes, depending a little bit on your prover. One thing I have to mention, when you prove, please take care that you have enough humidity, because you saw already the bread go very dry, very fast, and that's why we need a high humidity while proving. So, our breads are proved. Now, we start to cut, and as you like, just give some small cuts, not too deep, cut very light, not too strong, just let the knife do the job. All right, now let's bake. Steam. We give also here 5 minutes before we drop the temperature. and start. So, now we have a nice selection of our gluten-free breads. I would say very attractive breads. We have a nice crust color, nice shape, nice dough development. We have a nice texture, typical for bread. You see, we have a nice crust. You heard it probably. It's also crispy bread. The texture of the bread is very nice, typical for bread. So, what else you want? From the same bread, we can make as well specialty breads, adding tomato, adding olives, maybe some Italian herbs. So we get a Mediterranean baguette. We can add some mixed seeds to make a nice seeded bread. We still have a nice texture even with a lot of seeds. And when you look at this bread and you smell, this smells like bread. So now it's your turn. Enjoy baking and see you next time.